Today, I'm going to show you how to install this endoscope kit from King Gubby Designs on the Laser Master 2 and how I'm going to use it in Lightburn. My name's Jim, and this is The Edge of Tech. So endoscopes can be used for a lot of things, and a really cool application could be on a laser like this one. So King Gubby Designs reached out and said, hey, you want to check this out? And of course, I said yes. So we're going to install it on the Laser Master 2. Now, this is not the Laser Master 2 Pro, but there is a kit for that, and it'll do the exact same thing. The install is super simple, especially if you followed the last video and did the air assist. The install itself takes less than 5 minutes. It's very, very fast, and that's because King Gubby Designs came up with a really cool link option. All you have to do is put your links together, put it on the bottom of the laser, and you're really good to go. So let's install it. We're gonna start out by showing what the kit comes with. It comes with a camera, if you order the camera. My suggestion is order it because you probably don't have one at home. And this one we know fits inside of the mount here. Now, if you have one at home, that's fine. You can always reach out to King Gubby and make sure it fits in their mount. And if not, I'm sure he could hook you up with a mount that does work. The other thing we got is the pieces here. Now, this is very familiar, as you saw in the air assist video. We're not going to use that today or the screws that came with it, but we are going to use this right here. Now, this piece allows us to use the air assist and the endoscope. So we want to make sure we keep that. Of course, we have some connector pieces and we have the piece to allow the screw the endoscope in and make sure it doesn't go anywhere. It actually has a little screw in there, as you can see, and it'll tighten it in. That way it doesn't move. If you don't have the air assist installed, see that video. I'll put it up here and that'll get you as far as the mounting bracket and as far as you see in this video. So let's do it. So the first thing we want to do is move our air assist over. So we're just going to unclip that, unclip the holder like we had it. I'm going to move it to the other side of the laser. So it was down this side in the first video. I'm going to move it to this side now. And I'm going to click the actual air assist, make sure it's in the right way, facing that way there. I'm going to clip that into the left. Sometimes they're a little bit tough, which is great. That means these prints are good, tight tolerances. Now I'm going to take the little piece that looks like this, and this is what we're going to use to attach both now. Now this one is a pretty tight fit, so it's going to go up in here like this, and your air assist holder is going to go in there. So we're going to get it clipped in, and it is a super tight on mine. It's very, very tight. Then we're going to clip that up into the bracket like that. You can readjust this as needed. As you see, I actually have this backwards and I popped my tube out. I didn't realize it. So that should be more like this and the tubing should go down in there. So I'll have to fix that. You can move that wherever you want it. And that's where the next pieces come. Clip one in. If you're listening over there, holy crap on this fit here because they are tight today. Woo! All right, so I got the first one clipped in. Let's do two. Just for the heck of it. I got two clipped in here and now those are really tight fits here. And for the video, I'm actually gonna use the white one here. I like that to show on the video a little bit better. We're gonna take our endoscope and push it into the hole like this. So I got the endoscope pushed in. It's a little bit past the threads, which is fine. And I'm just gonna tighten down that bolt right there with an Allen wrench to hold this thing in place. Now it doesn't take much. You don't wanna crank on it, just enough to hold it into place so it's locked into the mount like this. Then all we do is clip that mount in right here and we have ourselves an endoscope camera. Now that it's mounted, it's clipped in, you can move this wherever you want to see it. The next step is just running this cable and we'll get it plugged into a computer. So let's do it. To run the cable, it is super simple. I am actually going to run it along the same path as the air tubing. So I'll have to actually clip those zip ties, but I'm going to throw one side over there and just get my cable ready like this. Clip the zip tie that I used for my air assist. Now you could run this through the loom. I believe there's plenty of room in the loom if you want to. For this build, I'm not gonna, mostly because I'm probably going to put this on the Laser Master Pro, which this kit also works on. You can jump on KingGubbyDesigns.com. The link will be in the description. You can get this kit for the Pro as well. Get everything tied up so it's not in the way. You do it how you want to do it. Just don't go too tight and crush your tube here. So now everything is secured. It's not gonna go anywhere. Don't forget to clip your zip ties. So at this point, the install is final. All we have to do is plug it in and adjust the camera to where we want it. Let's do it. Just a quick heads up to show you, you'll know it's on as soon as you plug it into the computer and the drivers recognize the light comes on. There's a light right here. I'm gonna go to control tab on Lightburn, hit the fire button at 25%, just so we see a dot. You can kind of see the dot right in front of my finger here. So my air assist, that's good. I probably will move it a little bit closer. And then as far as the camera goes, I'm gonna aim it what I think will be at that dot. And if you think the camera is too low, you can always take a link out so you get more of a direct angle down. Looking at this, I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take one of these links out so I can move the camera up a little and give us more of a direct downward shot. So I plugged in the camera, as we talked about earlier, to the USB drive, and Lightburn is what I use to run my lasers if you've seen any of my other videos. So what I'm gonna do is come over here to the camera tab. So normally it's on cuts. We're gonna go over here to the camera tab in the right side, come up to camera, and you can now have multiple cameras in Lightburn. This particular one for me is called USB 2.0 VGA UVC webcam. I'm gonna click on that and look at this. That is now showing the endoscope right in Lightburn. If I come over here on the right side and maybe I click and I make a circle, we'll just call it a circle like that, and then I tell my laser to go to the center of the circle, what we're seeing here is the camera, the endoscope. If I put my finger in here, you can see it just like that. I do have it pretty close, and you can see my finger is in there like this, but you can see that it actually gets super close if you want it to. Where I think this would be cool is for focusing your adjustable focus lasers, especially on the Laser Master 2 that I'm using here. In this video, if I go to the Move tab, I go to Power, I'm on 25%, and I hit Fire. Now I go over here to Camera, you can see that dot now. A lot of people do this on black paper. You can do that if you want to. But if I adjust the focus, you can actually see where your focus spot is. Now, when you're adjusting focus, you want to make sure it's as small as possible. So if I bring it down and bring it down like this, and it's really small, and then it starts getting bigger like that, you're too far. So look, I can adjust this down to almost perfect focus at 75 millimeters, which is what I use my G8 lens at. And now I know this laser's pretty dang close to focus. And I think that's a pretty awesome feature to use this endoscope on. Now, if I go to the Move tab and turn it off, there we go. You can see in the camera, it shuts itself off, which is great. But the other cool thing is you can adjust this and watch burns as well. Now, you can watch it from this close, that's totally fine. I have a little circle here. Let's just go to the cuts tab. Now I created this circle in the middle. I can hit frame. If I go back to my camera here, if I hit frame, I can see where it's gonna go. Looks like I was overlapping another test I already did. Try that again. Great. And all I'm doing is hitting shift and then the frame button. But now the cool thing is, now I do realize that the camera is not right side up. So I'll probably take that screw a little bit loose and twist it so it is right side up. But for this video, I just wanted to show how to mount it and keep this video as quick as I can. So the other cool thing is if I hit start here, you can actually watch the laser burn. But it really does a cool job of getting in there and kind of showing what you're burning. And in my thought, I really want to use this to focus this laser. So now I showed you how you can connect the camera straight into Lightburn and actually see what you're burning. Now you can do that with other webcams as well. You can set one up above and watch it right through Lightburn if you want to, and that kind of thing. But this is really cool with the endoscope, and I think it's gonna be awesome for, especially for focusing your laser much tighter. So you just saw the install and how I'm gonna use it in Lightburn. Specifically on this particular one to do the focusing. Now, I think it's a really cool option to have if you just want to watch the laser burn down there. You could probably adjust some settings in Lightburn to really make it look better, Also, I'm gonna spin the camera so it actually shows the right angle as well. That's something you can do while in Lightburn, so check that out. All you have to do is back the little set screw out and then spin the camera so it's right side up. It'll be a lot easier to see then. But overall, I think this is a really cool idea. I think there's a lot of different applications for something like this, and because Lightburn is now allowing multiple cameras, you can actually switch between them, which is really cool too. So how would you use an endoscope on your laser? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it, because maybe it's something I haven't thought of yet, and maybe a video coming up, you never know. So thanks again to King Gubby Designs for sending the endoscope kit over. I really appreciate it. I can't wait to see what you would do or what you do with these. So if you have one, let me know in the description below. I'd love to see that. Jump on Twitter and even tag hashtag Hotmakes, and maybe we can show what you're doing with your endoscope on the Hotmakes show that goes live on Mondays. Well, there's a lot more laser stuff coming, so stay tuned. I can't wait to get it all to you. But until next time, keep burning.